हेलो एवरीवन, लास्ट क्लास में हमने कॉम्बिनेशन रिएक्शन डिस्कस की थी और आज हम शुरुआत करने जा रहे हैं डीकम्पोजिशन रिएक्शन से। देखो, डीकम्पोजिशन रिएक्शन, द वर्ड डीकम्पोज मींस ब्रेक डाउन, यानी किसी चीज का स्प्लिट होना, टूट जाना। ठीक है, तो डीकम्पोजिशन रिएक्शन मीन्स जब आप कोई एक सिंगल सब्सटेंस को दो या दो से ज्यादा सब्सटेंसेस में ब्रेक डाउन करते हो या स्प्लिट डाउन करते हो, स्प्लिट करते हो, उन रिएक्शंस को हम कहते हैं डीकम्पोजिशन रिएक्शंस। तो द रिएक्शंस इन विच वन सिंगल सब्सटेंस स्प्लिट्स into two or more substances। देखो, कोई एक substance है, वो टूट रहा है, दो या दो से ज्यादा substances में break down हो रहा है। But ये reaction ऐसे possible नहीं है कि like we have just kept the substance and it is the things are happening until and unless any external source is given to it। So generally this reaction takes place under three conditions। Number one, heat। Number two, sunlight provided। And number third is electricity। Right? जब decomposition reaction in the presence of heat होगी, उस reaction को हम बोलेंगे thermal decomposition reaction। जब रिएक्शन सनलाइट की प्रेजेंस में होगी, उसको हम बोलेंगे फोटोकेमिकल डीकम्पोजिशन। और जब रिएक्शन होगी इन द प्रेजेंस ऑफ इलेक्ट्रिसिटी, उसको हम बोलेंगे इलेक्ट्रोलिटिक डीकम्पोजिशन। राइट, सो देयर आर थ्री टाइप्स ऑफ डीकम्पोजिशन रिएक्शंस: थर्मल, दैट इज हीट; फोटोकेमिकल, दैट इज सनलाइट; इलेक्ट्रोलिटिक, दैट इज इलेक्ट्रिसिटी। सो फर्स्ट आई एम गोइंग टू स्टार्ट विद thermal decomposition reaction, that is heat। See, thermal decomposition reaction, so the reactions which takes place under the presence of heat, under the presence of heat is termed as thermal decomposition reaction। So देखो, ये reaction क्या होगी, जब तक आप heat provide नहीं करोगे उस substance को, ये reaction possible नहीं है। और जब आप इस एक substance को heat provide कर रहे हो और वो break down हो रहा है दो या दो से ज्यादा substances में, तो ऐसे reactions को जिसमें आप heat खुद से provide कर रहे हो, उन reactions को हम कहते हैं endothermic रिएक्शन, यानी कि वो रिएक्शन इन विच हीट इज गिवन टू दैट पर्टिकुलर सब्सटेंस, दैट मीन्स हीट इज एब्सॉर्ब। एंडो मीन्स इन, थर्मिक मीन्स हीट, दैट मीन्स हीट इज गिवन टू दैट पर्टिकुलर सब्सटेंस, दैट मीन्स हीट इज एब्सॉर्ब्ड बाय द सब्सटेंस, और हीट इज एब्सॉर्ब्ड इन द रिएक्शन। नाउ we have some examples of thermal decomposition reactions, right? And I'm going to start with the first example, that is ferrous sulfate। First of all, ferrous means Fe2+, right? There are two types of valency of iron, one is ferrous and number two is ferric। IC हम यूज करते हैं हायर वैलेंसी के लिए, जैसे यहां पर टू और थ्री में अगर कंपेयर करो तो थ्री ज्यादा हायर है, और OUS us हम यूज करते हैं लोअर वैलेंसी के लिए, राइट? सो Fe2+ इज ferrous एंड सल्फेट इज SO4-2-। सो ferrous सल्फेट इज बेसिकली FeSO4, राइट? बट अगर हम देखें कि क्रिस्टलाइन फॉर्म में फेरस सल्फेट प्रेजेंट होता है, तो वो फेरस सल्फेट प्रेजेंट होता है इन द फॉर्म ऑफ FeSO4.7H2O। ठीक है, this 7H2O represents the water of crystallization, right? So after heating this, we will get pure ferrous sulfate, right? But after heating this ferrous sulfate, what will happen? Just see. Suppose I have taken the test tube, right? And I have taken ferrous sulfate crystals, which are green in color, light green in color, and I have started igniting it, right? Here I have started burning it. So after some time, what will happen? This green color will be converted into brown color. That means Fe2O3 will be formed. Brown deposit represents here Fe2O3, which is ferric oxide, right? And along with this, there are two suffocating gases also evolved. That is SO2 and SO3. This is sulfur dioxide. 2 means di. This is sulfur trioxide. That is 3. So, in this way, it is heated and so the reaction formed will be FeSO4 on heat will be converted into Fe2O3 plus SO2 plus SO3. These two are suffocating gases, right? And this is that brown deposit, ferric oxide, and this is ferrous sulfate, which is green in color. Another example, second example is lead nitrate we are going to start, right? Second example is lead nitrate, right? That what will happen if this will be heated. So first of all, let me tell you, this is white in color, white powder. I have taken this lead nitrate in a test tube, white powder, that is lead nitrate. Upon heating, brown fumes will be evolved. देखो इसमें क्या होगा? Brown fumes evolve होंगी. And these brown fumes represent the evolution of NO2 gas, right? And obviously this white color powder will also be converted into brown, that is lead oxide. यानी कि क्या होगा? White colored powder, that is lead nitrate, will be decomposed into brown deposit, that is lead oxide, along with the brown fumes, that is NO2 gas. So the reaction will be like this. This will be 2 PbO plus 4 NO2 plus O2, right? And this represents again brown fumes. Understood? I am starting with the third example, that is calcium carbonate. See, calcium carbonate, again, calcium carbonate upon heating will give calcium oxide and carbon dioxide gas, right? Calcium oxide and carbon dioxide gas. So examples of thermal decompositions are over. I am going to start with the photolytic or photochemical decomposition. Photochemical decomposition, which takes place in the presence of sunlight, right? We have two examples of photochemical decomposition: AgBr, that is silver bromide, and AgCl, that is silver chloride. So first of all, these two salts are white in color, both. Right. Right. We have taken this AgCl powder, white in color, and we have kept it in the presence of sunlight. Same with this case. We have taken AgBr and we have kept in the presence of sunlight. Sun rays will fall upon this. Sun rays will fall upon this. These white powders, these both white powders will turn into which color? Gray color. That means they are left with over only Ag. Chlorine and bromine gases will be evolved. So the reaction formed will be 2AgCl in the presence of sunlight, H nu. H nu is the symbol of sunlight. This will form 2Ag plus Cl2. In that case, 2AgBr, that means in the presence of sunlight, 2Ag plus Br2. Right? So these are the examples of photochemical decomposition, and one use is also there, that what is the use of these two reactions. So there is one use, that they are used in black and white photography. This is the use, and these are the reactions, this one and that one. Now, I am going to start with the electrolytic decomposition. See, electrolytic decomposition, that means breakdown of the substance in the presence of electricity, right? So one common reaction or one common process, that is electrolysis, we will discuss. That H2O water upon electricity or upon the supply of electricity, it will be decomposed into H2 plus O2. This is the reaction for the electrolytic decomposition. So we are done with decomposition and its types. So let's have a quick review what we have studied so far. See, thermal decomposition reaction, right? What we have studied, number one,